For more than four decades, the National Football Foundation has been honoring the men who make the game so great. Honoring them each year in New York, the list of scholar athletes includes such former greats as Merle Olsen from Utah State, Gary Bevan from UCLA, Dave Remington of Nebraska, Pat Hayden of Southern Cal, Mark Harmon, UCLA, and Doug Flutie of Boston College. The centerpiece of the National Football Foundation is the Hall of Fame, making a move from Kings Island, Ohio to South Bend, Indiana. The key element in its growth has been the involvement from the local chapters of the National Football Foundation, including Arizona, made up entirely of volunteers, who tonight honor its scholar athletes. To be a scholar athlete, you have to be brass. And one of our college scholar athletes was plenty.
Again, the pressure's on Pulaski, and that pass is picked off by Adam Brass.
Arizona State defensive back Adam Brass was second on the team with tackles with 83 total. Number 26 led the Devils to a 6-5 record. His 3.25 grade point average helped earn him all academic honors for the Pac-10 and the National Football Foundation Scholar Athlete Award. In Flagstaff, Terry Belden got his kicks playing for the NAU Lumberjacks, handling double duties as the team's punter and kicker. He averaged 44 yards a boot, including 18 of 50 yards or better. Was 15 of 24 in field goals and rarely had a kickoff return for the 4-7 Jacks. His 3.45 GPA in social studies helps make him a three-time Big Sky All-Academic and a Football Foundation Scholar Athlete. In the high schools, Chris Rattay of Mesa helped guide the Jackrabbits to the state championship. Number 22 rushed for nearly 700 yards and 9 touchdowns. Battling through some adverse conditions, his father and coach Jim Rattay undergoing eye surgery, it inspired Chris on the field and in the classroom where he locked down a 4.1 grade point average. The Mountain View Toros made it all the way to the finals thanks to the play of number 62, Lane Adams. The defensive lineman always in the backfield.
He steps up and he's sacked. Lane Adams.
The Toros' leading tackler, he tackled the books even harder, securing a 4.08 grade point average and hopes to continue his studies at Brigham Young.
Lane Adams and can't do it.
Usually a surprise to find the Cardinals scoring here in the Valley. Not if you look to Glendale High, where Alistair White was lighting up the opposition. Whether on the receiving end or out of the backfield, White was unstoppable. And now this Cardinal's gonna be a Cardinal. His 3.6 grade point average, good enough for Bill Walsh and Stanford. There's no calling the foundation's honor list Bush League. Unless, of course, you're talking about the addition of Frankie Bush from South Point Catholic. The standout linebacker was a three-year varsity letterman. 5'10", 204 pounds of muscle, Frankie's 4.0 GPA hopes to muscle him into the Ivy League. This might look like a blue light special. Buena's special way of highlighting their standout linebacker, Brian Babich. Babich was just shy of breaking the school record for defensive points in Sierra Vista, and it's easy to see why he's a top candidate. With his 4.0 grade point average, he has also earned a four-year ROTC scholarship.
Mesa. Graham Lee.
From Fighting Colts to Mustangs and the General Lee, Graham Lee, who guided Dobson to a 7-4 record, threw for nearly 1,400 yards, 7 touchdowns, and had only 3 intercepts. He also came up with one of the plays of the year.
Wants the run, fumble on the play. He picks it up again. Now he goes the other way. Graham Lee, he may score. Touchdown, Dobson.
On the run, Graham didn't skip his duties in the classroom, where he locked down a 4.1 grade point average. A real Tiger, he'll play for Pacific next year. One of the best-kept secrets at quarterback, Travis Williams from up on the rim. The standout for the Mogollon Mustangs threw for nearly 2,000 yards and 26 touchdowns. He ran for another 8. His grades help place him second overall in his class. A 4.1 student, he'll attend Arizona State. Troy Head for mayor. No, he's not running for office, just running the offense for the Mayor Wildcats. Whether he was airing it out or running for the end zone. A 3.56 GPA, third in his class, Troy will head for college and prove eight-man football is for real. More, more, more. That was part of the battle cry at Paradise Valley this year, thanks to outside linebacker Lance Moore, number 88. He was responsible for 47 tackles, 3 sacks, and an intercept. Doubling as a tight end with 14 catches, earning him All-State honors, his 3.9 grade point average might be his best stat altogether, as he hopes to play for BYU. The Apaches were always on the warpath down in Nogales, thanks to tight end Ben Coronado, number 80. He was a big-time catch. He led the league in receptions with 47, good for 840 yards. With a 3.7 grade point average, he'll go on to play at West Point Military Academy. It was always an uphill battle when you played Morenci, thanks to Lance Hill. This rangy tight end always had him on the run. Hill led the Wildcats in catches, scored 5 touchdowns, and also led the team defensively with 12 sacks. And perhaps the best for last, a 4.58 grade point average. It's easy to see why Matt Hahn was leading the defense for the Cactus Cobras. A real sticker, Hahn was always around the ball and hopes to go to the U of A and study engineering.